So this is the last example, which is example 5 under differentiation using the first principle. So you have this question where they ask you to differentiate this mathematical function. Don't forget, in this case, you can see you are differentiating y with respect to t, because the dependent variable is y in this mathematical function and the independent variable is t. So if I want to differentiate this mathematical function, I'm differentiating y with respect to t, which is dy dt. So please let's note that. So it's not every case that you have dy dx. So it depends on what the dependent and the independent variable is in that particular mathematical function. So in this case, if you want to differentiate this, you will see that in this case you've got y equal to t squared minus 64 divided by t minus 8. So to differentiate this, I will just see, is there a way of simplifying this mathematical function further? If yes, then I can proceed to split it. If no, then that means there's another approach that I'm supposed to use to differentiate it, which you call the quotient rule. But in this case, let's first check, can we simplify this fraction further, which is this mathematical equation, which is a fraction further? Yes, let's see. You see that it's easy for you to split it further because you have t squared minus 64 divided by t minus 8. So this 64, don't forget, is a perfect square. So you can say this will become t squared minus 64 can be expressed as 8 raised by 2, because 8 times 8 will give you 64. Then divided by t minus 8, then your y now, I'm still splitting that function further, will become, don't forget, this is t squared minus a squared, so this is difference of 2 square root, if you still remember from your matrix, which says if you have difference of 2 square, you can simplify it as we have a squared minus b squared, it becomes a minus b into bracket a plus b. So you can use the rule of this difference of 2 square, which is what you know from matrix, to simplify t squared minus a squared further. To say if you have a squared minus b squared becomes a minus b into bracket a plus b, because when you do that, it will still give you t squared a squared minus b squared. So if I want to use that rule, I can simplify t squared minus a squared to become t minus 8 into bracket t plus 8, because I'm using the difference of 2 square root. Then this will divide t minus 8. Then from there, your y will give you y equal to t minus 8 into bracket t plus 8 over divided by t minus 8. So now you can see now that this t minus 8, we cancel this t minus 8, then that means your y will become t plus 8. So you see that based on this simplification, using the difference of 2 square root, we have been able to simplify this mathematical function, which is y equal to t squared minus 64 divided by t minus 8. And it's now simplified to become y equal to t plus 8 using this basic rules of simplifying mathematical equation further. So based on this now, I just need to go and now differentiate my y equal to t plus 8 to get the differentiation of this mathematical function. So if I do that now, that means I need to find my dy dt. If I differentiate y with respect to t, because I'm differentiating y with respect to t, so it's not y with respect to x, in this case it's y with respect to t. So my dy dt will become, don't forget, this is t raised by 1. So when you differentiate this t raised by 1, you are differentiating you are taking the value in the power of t, which is 1. You multiply it by the quotient of t raised by 1, which is also 1. Then you bring your t raised by 1 back, then you subtract it from 1, you remember the rule. Plus, when you differentiate your 8, which is a constant, it becomes what? 0. And that means your dy dt would become 1 times 1, which is 1 t raised by 0 plus 0. Then your dy dt would give you, don't forget, anything raised by 0 is 1. So t raised by 0 will become 1 plus 0. Then your dy dt will give you 1 times 1, which is 1 plus 0. And your dy dt, which is the final answer, would give you 1. And that is the answer to this particular problem.